Now that we've learned about inverse trig functions, we can now solve right triangles that we couldn't solve before. Let's take a look at an example. Now remember, to solve a right triangle means to find the lengths of all the sides and the measure of all of the angles. Notice we're given the lengths of two of the sides, as well as we know the measure of angle C is 90 degrees. So we need to find the measure of angle A, the measure of angle B, and the length of side C. Let's start by determining the length of side C. And since we have a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem. So we know c squared must be equal to a squared plus b squared, where c is the unknown, so we have c squared equals a squared. Well, a is the side that's opposite angle A, so a is equal to 6 meters, so we'll have 6 squared plus b squared, where b is 12 meters, so we'll have 12 squared. So we have c squared equals to be 36 plus 144. So we have c squared equals, this would be 180. And now to find c, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. We only have to take the principal square root because we know c has to be positive. So we have c equals the square root of 180. But this can be simplified. 180 is equal to 9 times 20, where 9 is a perfect square. And 20 is equal to 4 times 5, where 4 is a perfect square. And notice that 9 times 4 is 36, also a perfect square, which means you can write square root of 180 as 36 times 5, and the square root of 36 is equal to 6, so the exact value of c would be 6 square root 5. Of course, this would be meters. Let's also find a decimal approximation for this. 6 second x squared brings up the square root 5, and enter. And to verify that this is correct, let's also compare this to square root 180. This verifies that we did simplify our square root correctly. So c is approximately 13.42 meters. And now let's find the measure of angle A. Now notice that we can use any of the three sides of the right triangle depending on what trig function we want to use. If we want to use the tangent of angle A, where the tangent function is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, we could say tangent A is equal to 6/12. If we did want to use, let's say, the sine function, since the sine function value is the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, we could write sine A equals 6 divided by 6 square root 5. We probably would not want to use the rounded value because that would give us more of an error when determining the measure of angle A. But for this example, let's go and use the tangent function, which means the tangent of angle A must be equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, which would be 6/12. Of course, this simplifies to 1/2. So we have tangent A is equal to 1/2. Now we can use inverse trig functions to find the value of A. If we want to solve this equation for A, we can take the inverse tangent or arctangent of both sides of the equation. Because arctangent and tangent are inverse functions, they undo each other, and therefore arctangent tangent A is just equal to angle A. And on the right side of the equation, we have arctangent 1/2 or inverse tangent 1/2, where 1/2 is a tangent function value, and this expression is equal to the angle that has a tangent function value of 1/2. So to find this angle, we'll have to use a calculator because this trig function value does not result in a nice reference angle. So now we'll go to the calculator. We want our angle to be in degrees, so let's go ahead and check our mode. So we'll press the mode key. We'll change the third row to degree, highlight it, and press enter. back to the home screen, and now we're going to press second tangent for inverse tangent or arctangent, and then enter 1/2 and enter. So angle A is approximately, let's round it 2 decimal places, let's say it's approximately 26.57 degrees. Now before we find the measure of angle B, let's go and find the measure of angle A again using a different trig function. Let's say we wanted to use the sine function value instead. Remember, the sine function is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. So again, if we reference angle A, we can say sine A is equal to the opposite side, which is 6, divided by the hypotenuse, which is 6 square root 5. Well, again, notice how this simplifies nicely to 1 divided by square root 5. So we have sine A equals, this would be again 1 divided by square root 5. And now we'll take the inverse sine or arc sine of both sides of the equation to solve this for A. And again on the left side, if we take the inverse sine of sine A, the two functions undo each other because they're inverses. So we have angle A is equal to inverse sine of 1 divided by square root 5. Now we'll go back to the calculator to make sure we get the same angle that we did when we used the tangent and inverse tangent function. So now we're going to press second sine for inverse sine or arc sine, and it was 1 divided by square root 5. Notice how, of course, angle A is still the same. It's approximately 26.57. And this was degrees. And of course, back over here, we should change this equal sign to an approximation symbol. Now to find angle B, we could use another trig equation, but remember for a right triangle, the two acute angles must be complementary or have a sum of 90 degrees. So we can say that angle B is going to be approximately equal to 90 degrees minus the measure of angle A, which is 26.57 degrees, which means angle B would be approximately 63.43 degrees. And now we've solved the triangle. We were given two sides and an angle, and we found the measure of angle A as well as the measure of angle B and the length of side C. I hope you found this helpful.